Hello everyone, today I'm making a nice brown stew and I'm using beef. Okay, I got some oil in my pot heating up and I've got some onions. I chopped up three onions. Here's it, and I'm going to add it in the pot. And then, where is it now? Add a bay leaf. Want me a little? Oh. Now I'm going to brown the onions. That bay leaf already makes it so delicious. You can add allspice if you like. You can add now your a little bit of chopped carrot and celery. That's up to you. I'm going to add the baby carrots in the stew. I'm going to wipe my mushrooms with a paper towel. And I also have some baby potatoes for the stew, and then I have some beef. This is a free range beef that I bought, a big pack, and this is half of it. Then I cut it up, but what I did was I left it in the fridge for about 2 days, and that just helps with the meat to be a little bit more tender than normal. But if you didn't do that, or you don't have it, or just want to use whatever meat you like, please do so. And of course, with my brown stew, what I add is I add a tablespoon of dark soy, and I also add a little bistro. It is not necessary, but I love it. That's just how I like to have my brown stew. Please make it to your taste. And of course, salt and lots of black pepper. And also you can brown your onions. Remove the onions, then you can brown your meat. It's entirely up to you. Or you can brown them together. Okay. So all you do is like, you have your mushrooms and then you just wipe it with a paper towel, that black itches. You can take off the stem as well. I throw it all in if you want to. Sorry guys, just let me know about a lot of people have inquired about my cookbooks. Please go in the description box and you'll find all the information. And if you want to purchase it, wait, let me just go fetch it. Here is my first one with a lot of traditional Cape Malay food. And this is the latest one with a mixture of different kinds of food, a variety. And you can get it on online, Take a Lot, Raru, Loot SA, and you can get it nationwide at exclusive books. Your leading bookstores, Bargain Books, P&A, CNA, just ask around. If the store don't have it, Just inquire for them to order it for you. Okay. En nou soek ek weer vir my lepel. Nimmer frik het wel. Kom aan met my. If you want to serve this with mashed potato, just omit the baby potatoes in the stew itself. And if you're going to have it with rice or just on its own with a crusty bread, the potatoes are optional, no? But we're going to have it with rice. So that means we're going to add potatoes. Okay, and we'll be right back. Okay, now I'm going to add my meat. Okay, now it's just a matter of browning. It will take about 15 minutes to 20 minutes. I've also got about 6 to 8 cloves of garlic. I'm going to add it midway through the browning. And then, of course, some hot, warm water. And I'm going to cook the meat for about 50 minutes to an hour. And then I'm going to add the rest of the ingredients and let that bubble away. And once the potatoes are soft, the stew is done. Okay, and we'll be right back. Okay guys, the meat and the onions are lekker browning. I'm going to add my garlic. Okay. Another 10 minutes and then I'm going to add the water. Sorry guys, I almost forgot. Some black pepper. Please do to your taste. A teaspoon of salt. Again, taste it afterwards. See if you like it. Okay. And then at this stage, I add my soy sauce. My dark soy. You do not have to add it. It's just a personal preference, taste, tablespoon. See? Okay. Let this go for a few more minutes. Okay, it's been going for a little while. 5 to 8 minutes. Now I'm going to add about 3 cups of hot water. And I'm going to let it cook on a medium simmer, gentle cook for about an hour. Okay, let me put on the lid. There we go. See you just now. Okay guys, I'm back. The meat has now cooked for about, actually it went for an hour and a half. So please just check your meat. Not all meats cook for the same time. So do the test where you take your lipo and you press through the meat to see if it breaks apart in a certain way. There we go. It comes off. Can you see? So now I'm going to add the liquor. I'm going to add my baby potatoes. My carrots. And
my mushrooms. Stir.
I'm actually going to braise it now without any water for about 5 to 8 minutes depending, and then I'm going to add my water and also my small amount of water with the pesto. 1 second, guys. Okay, so I've stirred like 3 tablespoons of pesto with some cold water. You can add to your taste or not at all. And on the ready, I've got a couple of cups of hot water. And that's just, I'm not going to add too much because it's small potatoes. So basically now it's just about getting my vegetables soft, but not too soft, especially the carrots. You don't want popfish vegetables. Okay, it's braising now, liquor. Oh, the smell is amazing, man. Okay, so the braising here allows for more flavor, more color. It intensifies the flavor, actually. And, the color of the meat. What also helped it was, of course, the dark soy sauce. You don't have to add a tablespoon. You can add a drop or a teaspoon or not at all. It's really up to you. It's your food. You're going to must eat it. You must make according to your taste. I always encourage that. Lekker braise it, man. Lekker. Gonna go for another 5 minutes.
Takes me 5 minutes.
I'm gonna add some water, and this is just to get the vegetables cooking. A quick stir. I'm gonna put on the lid. I'm gonna cook this until the vegetables are soft. Then I'm gonna add my pesto. Stir again, and then the food is done. Okay, guys, there we go. I'm gonna add my pesto. Give it a pitchy. Second up. Oh yes, look at that. Look how that sauce is thickening up. Like I said, with rice. And I would personally not throw in any broccoli or cauliflower. It just overpowers and takes over. The flavors take over. And there we go, thickening up. Look at that. Look at that thick gravy, brown sauce. Look at that. Okay, guys, that's it. Brown stew. My version. And I break it at the pulse, which is a sign it's finished. Okay. Simmer. Meat is nice and tender. There we go. Brown stew, winter warmers, serve it with rice on its own. Soak it up with some crusty bread or with mashed potato. There we go. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll be back again with another video soon. Bye, everyone. Love you guys. Yummy.